Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to explain an error you might have seen in Google Tag Manager. This can pop up if you've implemented a Google Ads conversion tracking or remarketing tag. We're going to take a look at the error, I'll explain why it occurs, and show you the steps to fix it. Okay, so the error we're going to look at occurs if you've implemented a Google Ads tag on your website, but you haven't implemented a Google tag across your entire website. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to take a look. Let's start by navigating to Tags. We can see in my Google Tag Manager container that I have a number of different tags. The main thing I want to highlight is that there is a conversion linker tag for Google Ads, along with a Google Ads conversion tracking tag, and a Google Ads remarketing tag. Now let's click Preview to load Tag Assistant. We enter the URL of our website. And now let's click Connect. Our website loads, and Tag Assistant has loaded too. Now let's select the Tag Assistant tab. We can see the conversion linker tag and the Google Ads remarketing tag has loaded. At the top, we can see the tag ID for our Google Ads account. This is from the Google Ads tags that we've implemented using Google Tag Manager. Let's select the ID. We can now see the warning or error message. When we hover over it, it says, "This Google tag should have been loaded before sending an event. To fix this, add a Google tag to your container and configure it to fire on the initialization all pages trigger." So we're seeing this warning because we're sending data to Google Ads, but we haven't implemented a Google tag for our Google Ads account. This means we need to add a Google tag to our container to remove this warning message. I need to highlight this is a warning and not an error. So if you're using the dedicated Google Ads conversion tracking tag or the remarketing tag along with the conversion linker tag, you can continue to use these and ignore the warning. You're not losing data. However, the benefit of adding a Google tag with your tag ID from Google Ads is that you can use it to create remarketing lists in your Google Ads account. And you can use it to create page-based conversions without setting up additional tags. Okay, now let's walk through the steps to set up our Google tag. Let's head back to Google Tag Manager and let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag, Google Ads. And let's select Tag Configuration and choose Google Tag as the tag type. Now we need to get our Google Ads tag ID. This should be the same as the tag ID we found in Tag Assistant. So let's open the Tag Assistant tab. We're still looking at our Google Ads tag ID that we selected at the top of the interface. So let's copy the tag ID. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. You can now paste the tag ID into the tag configuration. However, if there are other existing Google Ads tags, like the conversion tracking and remarketing tags we saw in my container, then somebody might have already created a variable with the tag ID. So let's select the variable icon. We can see there is a variable named Google Ads ID. This is probably the same tag ID. To check this, let's click the information icon. And we can see this is the same tag ID we saw in Tag Assistant. So let's use this existing variable for our new tag. To do this, let's close the variable and select it from the list. we can see the tag ID will now use the value from the variable. Now we can scroll down and select triggering. Let's select the initialization all pages trigger. And let's save the tag. Now we can test our changes. Let's click preview. Tag Assistant reloads. And let's select our Google Ads tag ID at the top. The warning is no longer being displayed. By adding the Google tag with our tag ID from Google Ads, we've applied Google's recommendation to our implementation. Have you seen this warning in your Google Tag Manager container? Are you going to follow the steps we've covered to fix it? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments. And to learn even more about Google Ads, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel and check out my courses in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.